You feel like a nobody. You feel like you don't have it, like you can't do it. And the sad thing is that as long as you continue to believe that, it will be true. Your greatest heroes, the singers you look up to, the athletes you admire, the business people that you want to be more like, everyone you look up to who is a somebody today felt like a nobody at some point. They felt like a nobody until they believed that they could become a somebody. And so you feel like a nobody, but you can become a somebody. You can go from being the person who doesn't have it to being the person who does. From being the person who can't do it to being the person who can. But before you can go off and become that somebody that you're destined to be, you first need to believe that it's even possible. As much as I wish it weren't true, I know this. As long as you feel like a nobody, you will be stuck exactly where you are. I know this because for a long time, I was stuck feeling like a nobody. And for people who know me, they would think like, that's crazy. They would tell me that I'm being overly dramatic because what other people see is the achievements. My wife and I were married at 22. We have four amazing kids. That's an achievement. They see that I started my business when I was 23 and I built it into a multi-million dollar company. That's an achievement. They see that I have the chance to meet and work with some of the most extraordinary people, like some of whom are literally billionaires, and they see that as an achievement. The people who know me will hear this and think that I'm crazy or dramatic because they see what I have. They know what I've done. And what they would say to me is, why can't you be satisfied? What I hear is them saying, you have so much. Why can't you just be happy with what you have? But for me, I know that I hit the point years ago where I stopped growing. I hit the point where my high hopes, my vision, my dreams, the type of extraordinary life that I had up here in my head was outpacing my current reality. There came a point where I realized that I wasn't going to be as extraordinary as I assumed I would be. I don't know why I assumed it would all just happen, but I did. And so I was left asking, is this it? Have I run out of luck? Is this the high point of my life? Or worse, I was like, oh, did I miss the high point of my life? Maybe it happened a few years ago and I didn't even see it go by. I knew in my core that I wasn't on the path to becoming the person that I wanted to be. And it was crushing for me, because even though I could see all of this happening in slow motion, it's the accident that's happening right there in front of you and you're helpless to do anything about it. I didn't know what to do about this. My one word is extraordinary, extraordinary. And I felt so average. I felt mediocre. I felt like a nobody. And it took me a long time to figure this out. A lot of long, late night and early morning conversations with my friend Evan. I went on lots of long walks and listened to a lot of podcasts and audiobooks, and I read a lot, and I spent weeks and months even just like rolling things around in my head, reflecting on what I wanted, why I wanted it, and who I needed to become to get those things. And through all of that, it was the moment when I finally believed that I could be a somebody, when I finally had enough pride and enough confidence that I stopped feeling like a nobody and I started to feel like I could become a somebody. But this took work. Like, take my health. For example, I was out of shape. I was 50 pounds heavier than I am now. So what do you do if you are someone who's overweight like I was? You make excuses. You tell yourself you can't get fit. You tell yourself that you don't have the willpower to eat right. You can't exercise. You don't have the time. You don't have the money. It's too hard. That's what I told myself. Or take work. I was running a multi-million dollar company, but it wasn't what I envisioned. It wasn't what I would hoped it would be. It was always falling short of my expectations. So what do you do if you're struggling to build a business that's in your head or to leave a job or a career that you hate? You make excuses. You tell yourself you can't do it, that you don't have the time or the skill or the education or the money. It's just too risky, right? You may feel like you're too much in debt. You may feel like you're not making the money that you need to make. You may feel like you're not the parent that you need to be. Your relationships might be falling apart. You may be where I was, with this feeling like you're destined for more. You're destined for something so much more, but you just don't have what it takes to make it happen. What do you do in any of these situations? Do you make excuses? Do you give in? Do you give up? Do you stop living? No, you need to get yourself to a place where you can believe that you can be a somebody. Through all those late night talks and long walks and books and podcasts, through all of that, here's what I did. And it worked for me, and I believe it could work for you too. First, understand that you're not going to grow. You can't grow in all five areas of your life at the same time. It's too much change to try and overhaul your entire life, your health, your relationships, your work, your wealth, your finance and faith. It's too much. It was too much for me to try and fix my diet, to become a more patient and present father, to become a more understanding and supportive husband, or to become a stronger and more visionary leader, and to grow my business, and to change my mindset, and. It's just too much. I'd be way too scattered if I tried to focus on all areas of my life at the same time, but that's the trap that most of us fall into. It would just be impossible to try and change everything all at once. So start. Don't focus on change yet. It's too overwhelming. Start right here. Start by admitting that you're not happy. It's okay. It's okay not to be happy. You're not failing because you're not happy right now. You're not letting other people down because you're not happy right now. So give yourself permission to drop the facade and to admit to yourself and to those in your life that you're not happy with where you're at. You're not happy with what you have. You don't feel satisfied with where you're going. Next, you have to be willing to take responsibility for your current situation. Don't beat yourself up over this. We're not doing this to make you feel bad about yourself, but you have to take responsibility for where you're at. You have to take responsibility for what you have and for where you're going. And just think about this. If you're not willing to take responsibility for the decisions that you've made in the past, or the way that you've handled or reacted to certain situations, if you will not take responsibility for where you were, how are you going to take responsibility for where you're going, for your future? And then, once you've admitted that you're unhappy and you've taken responsibility, you need to do something that makes you feel proud, because you feel like a nobody. And the difference between feeling like a nobody and becoming a somebody is that nobodies are insecure like I was. They're ashamed like I was. They have doubt and they live in fear like I do still. But somebodies make themselves proud. They do things that they're proud of. Somebodies will go to bed tonight proud of what they've done. How will you go to bed tonight? Will you be proud of what you've done? Of who you are, of what you want, of where you're going? Is there something that you can do today to make sure that when you lay your head down on the pillow tonight, you can tell yourself it was a great day that you're damn proud of yourself. Yes, it may seem simple, but you can. You can start with small changes today. You can start by asking yourself, what's the one thing that you can do right now? What's the one thing that you can do today that makes you proud of the work, of your effort, of how you handled the current situation? And this is where you start. It may seem simple, but there are things that you can do that will make you feel just a little bit better about yourself. I'm 2 years into this, and there are lots of days when I feel like I didn't hit my true potential, where I've let myself down or I failed the people who are around me. But today, with all the effort I put in, my time, with all the growth, today I am proud of what I've done. When I lay my head on my pillow tonight, exhausted from the day I've had, from the work, from the focus, from the 10K run that I did, from building my company and focusing on my mission and the drive and the determination to stick to my ridiculous diet, I know that if I really push myself, that if I do hard things, which I tell myself I do, things that scare me, things that grow me, things that challenge me, I know that when I lay my head down on my pillow tonight, I will be proud of not only who I am, but the day that I've had. And that comes from believing and knowing deep within myself that it's all worth it because I am on the road to becoming a somebody. And I know that every day I have the chance to prove to myself that I'm gonna live this extraordinary life that's up here in my head and I'm gonna make this thing real or not. Or I'm gonna lose the day, I'm gonna lose the battle. I'm gonna start backsliding and I don't wanna do that because I am destined to be a somebody. You are destined to be a somebody. We just need to believe that that's true. So there you have it. Until next time, remember, you have to think big, you've got to be bold, and you must say yes. Sometimes I struggle to create things. And if you want to know what I do to get over it, check out this video right here. I think you'd like it a lot. You can see I have hair there. I'll see you over there.